Hi, welcome to your channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. I'm your host, Dr. Mohar M. Ghosh, and I'm back today with another awe-inspiring story for all of you. For those of you who are coming onto the channel for the first time, let me give you a brief about the channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. Generous, Gracious and Gallant was formed in 2015 on Facebook, and today we've got about 820 members there. On WhatsApp, we've got about 120 members, and we launched it on YouTube in May 2020, and as on date, we've got about 150 members on YouTube. Generous, Gracious and Gallant was formed with the objective of sharing inspirational stories of mankind so that we can bring about a change in the moral fiber of the present and coming generations. We also share daily inspiration with you, enabling you to put your best foot forward on a daily basis. Coming to our story, today we are going to hear about an inspirational woman who was so much in love with her husband that when she became aware of her husband's death, she decided to join the army and take revenge against the Nazi barbarians who were responsible for the death of her husband. Before we go on to the story, could I request you to please press the subscribe button and hit the bell icon so that you get a notification on every new video which I release for you on this channel. The heroine of our story is Maria Vasilyevna Oktyabrskaya. Let's learn a little bit about her. She was born on 16th August 1905 and she was one among 10 children. Her family was very poor and they lived in the Crimean Peninsula. Before World War II occurred, she worked in a cannery and was a telephone operator. In 1925, she married an Soviet army officer. She started taking a keen interest in military matters and she became involved in the Military Wives Council. There, she was trained as a nurse in the army and she also learned how to use weapons and drive vehicles. She said, when asked about her interest in military matters, "Marry a serviceman and you will serve in the army. An officer's wife is not only a proud woman, but also a responsible title." When World War II opened up, she was evacuated to Tomsk in Siberia. 2 years later, she learned that her husband had died fighting the forces of Nazi Germany near Kyiv in August 1941. When she heard this news after 2 years, she felt very angry and determined to fight the Nazis. She took it upon herself to write a letter to Stalin himself saying, "My husband was killed in action defending the motherland. I want to revenge those fascist dogs who brought death onto my husband and for the death of the Soviet people tortured by the fascist barbarians. For the purpose, I have deposited all my personal savings of 50,000 rubles in the National Bank in order to build a tank. I kindly ask to name the tank, fighting girlfriend, and send me on the front line as a driver of the tank. Stalin felt he had no choice and was advised by the State Defense Committee to go ahead, as it will have a positive effect on the morale of the desperate people and troops. In addition, we need to understand, in those days donations were common towards protecting the motherland, but these were mostly by men, and no one had volunteered to go and fight in the front line in addition to giving money. This resulted in Maria being sent on a training course for 5 months. This itself was uncommon, because in the fight for the motherland against the Nazi barbarians, as called by Maria, people were being trained for a very short period and being sent in unpainted tanks to the front line. Maria was trained for 5 months so that she could be idolized and also make a difference on the front line. Painted across her turret, T-34 tank, which was made with her donation, was the name in bold, Flying Girlfriend. Lot of people and troops took it as a joke or a publicity stunt, but Maria was made of sterner stuff, and as I will share with you going forward, she proved herself in 3 battles, was promoted, and also given the highest honor of the Hero of the Soviet Union, which is the highest honor available for soldiers of the Soviet Union in the battlefield. After the 5 months training, 38-year-old Maria was posted to the 26th Guard Tank Regiment in September 1943 as a driver and mechanic. As mentioned earlier, many took it as a publicity stunt and a joke, but Maria proved with her fighting skills that she was the best among the best. Her first battle took place on 21st October 1943. Her tank, which she commanded as a driver and mechanic, destroyed machine gun nests and artillery guns. Hit by gunfire, she disregarded her own safety, and despite orders to the contrary to stay safe and not go out, she leapt out of the turret, repaired the tank under heavy fire, and proceeded to join back the battle. For this act of bravery, she was promoted to sergeant. Month later, in November 17th and 18th, she got embroiled in another battle as part of the tank regiment in the town of Novajo Silo. She, along with the regiment, put forth an assault on the German positions. She was responsible for causing many casualties on the enemy. However, an artillery shell exploded near her tank and damaged the track. She could not proceed further, so she jumped out and carried out repairs to the tank under artillery fire and light machine gun firing. 2 months later, on 17 January 1944, she joined the offensive in Leningrad, Novgorod offensive. She drove a tank and demolished multiple machine gun posts and did away with multiple soldiers in their trenches. She also destroyed a German self-propelled gun. Again, an artillery shell burst near her tank and resulted in her tracks coming out. She paid scant regards to her safety, jumped out, and tried to repair the tank, which she successfully did so, brought it back into running condition, and while trying to board the tank again, was injured with artillery shells going into her head. She went into a coma for 2 months, and she was shifted to a hospital in Kyiv, but 2 months later, on 15th March, she went on to meet her maker. Maria, a totally inspirational woman who won the respect of her fellow soldiers and inspired multiple women to come forward and volunteer for the Soviet forces in the fight for the motherland. She not only contributed her life savings and wrote directly to Stalin saying that she wanted to join the battle as a tank driver. She paid for the tank, got it embossed as saying flying girlfriend, underwent 5 months training and joined 3 battles where she proved her bravery. An awe-inspiring woman who out of love for her husband decided to fight back against the Nazi barbarians who had killed her husband. Friends, if you like my awe-inspiring stories, request you once again to please subscribe to the channel by pressing the bell icon so that you get a notification on every awe-inspiring video which I'll be bringing for you. I also wanted to share with you that I'm a firm proponent of the concept of difference to one, which means that not all of us can make a difference to multiple people, but all of us can make a difference to someone in our community. Mankind is facing its biggest battle against the COVID-19 virus, and it's time we all united and took a stand to help one another. I'm sure you could make a difference to someone in your community, the ripples of kindness of which will spread out throughout the community and help us in the battle of COVID-19. Till we meet again with another awe-inspiring story, good luck, all the best, stay safe, wear a mask whenever you are going out, and do maintain social distance for the safety of you and your loved ones. Good luck, all the best, thank you.